My name is Maya Santangelo, and I am the 2016 Australasian Rolex Scholar of the Our Underwater Scholarship Society. I learned to dive when I was 14 years old, and I totally latched onto it. Diving became something that I wanted to make a career out of, but I never really had a reason why. It was just something I always loved doing. My experiences in diving definitely played a huge part in wanting to pursue marine biology, but one of the main things that really influenced me wanting to be a diver and a marine biologist for something bigger and making a positive difference in the world was actually learning about the Rolex Scholarship itself. I remember reading the application for the first time and feeling like I was being asked how I wanted to save the world, which was equally intimidating and inspiring for me at the time, but it's honestly what sparked that interest. I never wanted to just be a diver. I never wanted to study science just because I was a nerd. I all of a sudden had this inspiration to want to do it for something more. The ocean has provided so much in my life that it was natural to want to figure out how I could give back. Being awarded with a Rolex Scholarship, I now had this incredible opportunity to work with leaders in a variety of underwater fields and explore ways that I might like to make positive contributions to conservation and inspiring a more sustainable relationship with the oceans. I knew that if I really wanted to make a difference, I wanted to make it count. So I set out in pursuit of gaining new skills, knowledge, and real-world experience to help me become the best ambassador for the oceans that I could be. One of my favorite things about diving is that there are always new skills to learn to literally help you better explore the underwater world. My scholarship provided me with multiple opportunities to not only gain new skills, but to then go on to actually apply and practice them in subsequent experiences, particularly in dry suit diving, solo diving, and free diving. Going through my ADAS and AAUS scientific diver training was probably one of the most useful skills I could have done during my year with regards to pursuing a future in research. Training with the University of Tasmania was quite an intensive and at times exhausting experience with intense theory, drills, task loading, bad visibility, and diving with more gear than you could possibly imagine, but definitely an experience that brings you out on the other side a more confident and competent diver. On the extreme other end of the scale, learning to dive on just a single breath of air was a really fun new challenge that I took on during my year. I've been scuba diving for nearly half my life and had never had any formal training in freediving before. So training with Australian champion Adam Stern in Bali was a really awesome experience to learn what I was capable of when I trained my mammalian dive reflex properly, and learning how I could use this new skill to explore the underwater world in a way completely different than scuba. As a marine biologist, a big focus of my year was on gaining research experience and learning about different avenues in science that are helping contribute to our understanding of life in the oceans. I've always had a particular interest in studying predatory fish ecology, so you can probably imagine my excitement when I had the chance to start my year diving with great white sharks in South Australia. Working with the crew of Rodney Falk Shark Expeditions, I was able to learn about the ongoing studies as part of their research foundation. Diving with great white sharks is a seriously humbling experience. They're such impressive animals to be in the water with. But what was so cool about this experience was actually getting to sit down at the end of every day with Andrew Fox and individually identifying the sharks that we were seeing and learning about how just the simple photo identification is contributing to our understanding of their ecology and the time that they spend at the Neptune Islands. My research experience also took me somewhere that I hadn't really considered before, to a remote corner of Africa on the Indian Ocean coastline of Mozambique. Working with Marine Action Research and Marine Megafauna Foundation as a research intern, I was able to work on quite a variety of projects, everything from charismatic megafauna, humpback whales, whale sharks, manta rays, to the complete other end of the scale, surveying tiny nudibranchs. This experience definitely had it all when it came to gaining practical experience in the field and learning the realities of science on scuba. trying to survey nudibranchs in really surgy conditions and keeping up with mantas to collect the data that you need can be a real challenge. In pursuing science, rather than academia, I've always had an interest in learning how this knowledge can be applied to conservation through communication and policy. Early on in my year, I joined 2012 and 2013 Australasian scholars Yoli Balsiger and Stefan Andrews on a film shoot with the BBC Ocean team in South Australia. We were filming the annual mating aggregation of the giant Australian cuttlefish for part of Blue Planet 2. And this experience wasn't just about carrying heavy cameras around. It was an awesome chance to learn about the research that goes into productions like these. They're not just stunning natural history footage with David Attenborough's voice behind it. Science definitely plays an important part in how we tell these stories, and some of the new animal behaviors that we can document from them can definitely lead on to some new research coming out. When it comes to conservation, people will only protect what they care about, and they only care about what they understand. I joined 2015 European scholar Danny Copeland and a team of really passionate individuals in the Azores Islands to help create a virtual reality film about the mobula rays that aggregate around Santa Maria. What was really exciting about joining this project was that it was part of a really unique conservation initiative. The goal of creating the film was to present at the CITES Convention on International Trade of Endangered Species to help gain protection for these mobula rays to ensure that fishing practices don't threaten their survival. Rather than showing the delegates numbers on paper, we wanted to visually demonstrate to them why these animals were worth protecting. Helping on this project, I was able to experience all the elements of a film production, particularly the challenges that are involved with virtual reality. The level of effort and sometimes even risk that's involved with trying to document wildlife, particularly with such an important goal behind it, is something that I think is often underestimated. And there were definitely moments where we weren't sure if we were going to be able to pull it off. But more importantly, what was so rewarding was getting to be part of actually bringing to CITES the next best thing to taking these delegates on a dive with mobulas. Being in the water with these rays was really an incredible experience, and getting to watch it for the first time on the VR headset, I had this huge smile on my face because it was so epically immersive that it really was key to getting to educate these delegates on what they were voting to protect. Attending CITES was my first taste of conservation politics. This is where so much of the change happens with regard to the relationship that we have with the natural world. It was definitely an eye-opening and at times quite stressful experience, even just from the sidelines, to observe the realities that are involved.
Here we go.
Okay, I can now announce the results. The no is 20, abstentions 3, and yes, 110.
Yeah!
But to be part of it, to see the success of sharks and rays gaining protection, was hugely rewarding and actually really inspiring to see the positive momentum in the importance of protecting ocean species. This experience certainly demonstrated to me the value and power of media in educating people about life in the ocean. But what it made me realize was that maybe this wasn't how I wanted to tell the story. When I think about it, what really ignited my love for the ocean to want to make a career out of it were those amazing interactions I had experiencing marine life through diving. The underwater world is something so indescribably infectious that you don't want to keep those wonders to yourself. My experiences exploring the dive and expedition industry during my year really reinforced my passion for sharing the underwater world with others. These experiences were not only seriously once-in-a-lifetime opportunities to get to explore some of the most spectacular ecosystems on the planet, but hugely valuable in getting to learn what these world-class operations are all about. Expedition leaders have an amazing opportunity to enhance the experiences for others and ignite a curiosity for the underwater world, whether it's a long-standing history or a newfound love. Particularly in the shark diving industry, joining teams of really passionate individuals, it was amazing to witness just how people can go from simply having an interest in sharks or even a fear of sharks to shark divers and advocates in a heartbeat.
I didn't expect it to be so calming. I didn't feel scared at any point. I kind of just had fun with it.
They're beautiful.
It was awesome.
You see them in pictures and videos, but they're even better in person. Just amazing.
Whether it's diving with great white sharks in South Australia, schooling hammerheads in Cocos Island, or diving into schooling species in blue water with humpback whale singing in the background in Hawaii, it's magical moments like these that make you realize that you really cannot underestimate the power of seeing these animals in the wild. Something that really sparked my interest in my year was getting to learn from operators that have taken shark diving to a whole nother level. They're taking advantage of the time that they spend in the water to collect data on the marine life that they encounter. There remains so much to be explored about life in the oceans, and as divers, being able to experience things that others may only ever dream of, we have an amazing opportunity to contribute to that. As I continue to grow my knowledge and credibility as a marine biologist in the future, this is an avenue that I would really like to contribute to help bridge the gap between marine research and the dive industry and enhance the value of citizen science and the difference that I believe that it can make. My scholarship year has not only strengthened my passion for understanding life underwater, it has been invaluable in providing the drive to pursue this path of science for effective ocean conservation. Some of my most formative experiences have involved working alongside leading researchers to learn what questions we can ask to translate science into policy and how public outreach can spark an interest for science in others. In the Bahamas, volunteering with the world-famous Bimini Shark Lab provided a seriously intensive opportunity to explore all things shark research. Sharks have always captured my interest because of their unique physiology and important ecological role, and this was my chance to learn what it was like and what it takes to be a shark researcher with some of the best possible hands-on experience I could have ever dreamed of. You know you found a passion for something when conducting research on a large tiger shark at 4 a.m. is more appealing than sleep. Overall, something that I valued most on this journey was the incredible individuals I was able to meet along the way. From dive pioneers to leading researchers, expedition leaders, instructors, fellow students and volunteers, meeting people from such a wide variety of careers and scientific fields provided valuable insight into the realities, challenges and rewards of a life committed to the ocean. Experiencing this year has honestly been a lifelong dream, and I'm so grateful to everyone that has made it what it was. I can confidently say that the Rolex Scholarship has changed my life. My passions and future steps are now clearer than ever, and I can't wait to dive in.
Made it round South Korea.